Ambler resident Woodrow Grist is keeping the fire alive that fuels Ambler's new biomass furnace. It uses locally harvested cordwood to heat the community's water system and public facilities.
Good. See it sucking it in already.
Now, instead of burning fuel oil, the town's main offices are largely heated by a renewable resource. Ambler Mayor Morgan Johnson expects the furnace to divert the town's limited fuel stores to private residences.
We haven't been putting fuel in the fuel tanks so far. Operators are keeping the fire going, and hopefully that can happen throughout the winter, you know, and we can save a lot of money on stove oil.
The biomass furnace system, which was installed by the Alaska Native Tribal Health Consortium, or ANTHC, has been up and running since September. The system is a welcome source of renewable energy in a village off the road system, where fuel prices are an especially high burden. Ingemar Mathiasen, Ambler resident and Northwest Arctic Borough energy manager, says that Ambler's situation is even more precarious now due to climate change. As spring comes earlier and snowmelt recedes, the Copic River doesn't always stay high enough for fuel barges to make it to the village safely. That can force Ambler residents to rely on planes, the most expensive form of transportation.
You're dependent on faraway conflicts, like in the particular case right now, where Russia invaded Ukraine, that raises the cost for the entire world's supply of oil. And you don't want those. If you want stability, sustainability, you want to do the renewable resources at home first, as much as you can.
ANTHC decided to install a biomass furnace system because the forests surrounding Ambler can provide the town with the wood that fuels the furnace. Project manager Katya Karankevich says a steep jump in the price of heating fuel last fall makes the system even more important.
So with this big fuel spike that we've seen, it is a fantastic time for this system to come in to focus because it will be saving a lot more than originally projected.
With the installation of the biomass system, ANTHC estimates that the city will cut its annual oil consumption by approximately 3,500 gallons. That's $50,000 a year that will stay in Ambler.
You get the financial benefits of more jobs for biomass operators, more jobs for woodcutters, less cost for the city to have to operate and keep their doors open to the washateria, the laundry and the shower services. But then secondfold, the community is more independent.
Renewable energy systems like the Ambler furnace create a circular economy in the communities they serve. In Ambler, residents are paid for the wood that they gather, chop, and deliver to fuel the stove. And the money the city saves on fuel can be reallocated to supporting its residents. ANTHC has active projects in more than 80 communities across the state. These renewable energy programs that harvest wind, water, and other sources are expected to keep money in communities and put Alaskans on a path toward a more sustainable future. Projects like these mean a lot to rural Alaskans, where the cost of living makes everything that much harder. But lifelong Ambler resident Brian Wasoski believes renewable energy systems are an opportunity to change that and so much more.
So we can be independent and we can do the things that we need to do and feel a sense of pride. You know, if you're working, if you're clean, you feel better. You know, it's just the way it is. If you can provide for your family, buy shoes for your kids, food on the table, That is a sense of pride. It always has been for me. Now you're going to get me emotional.
While a wood-burning biomass furnace system may not be the right choice for every rural area, Karankevich says that ANTHC is working to help Alaska Native communities develop renewable energy systems that divest from fossil fuels. For Alaska Public Media, I'm Elyssa Loughlin.